Hi there. Today I'm going to show you about creating views in Microsoft Project. Okay, so a view in Microsoft Project is kind of a screen layout. So on the left hand side here we have a table. On the right hand side we have a chart of some description. In this case it's the Gantt chart. And this is actually called the Gantt chart view, and I can see that labeled on the left hand side in green writing just here. But I want to make some changes to this view. Okay, I want to make it stand out a little bit. It looks a bit plain to me, and perhaps I want to add additional columns. Okay, one that I usually add, and you may have seen this in a previous video, is the work column, like so. So I've just right clicked, inserted a column, and here we have the works. Now I could actually come in here and estimate some work effort as in addition to the duration. So that's a basic change. Something else that I like to do in views that I create, I'll use the text styles, and you'll see that here in the format ribbon. You can click text styles, and you know, I'm going to come in here and say for every summary task, make the background color, I'll make it kind of like this light green. Oh, that's a bit dark. Light green, there we go. And also for my milestones, I generally make the foreground color of those this dark blue here. I could go slightly darker, but that'll do for now. So yeah, green summary tasks, a milestone. So every time I create a new summary task or a milestone, you'll see that it'll instantly turn to that color. That's the text styles. So you know, if I put in here task 11 and you know, make a summary task above it, and you know, if I make this a summary task by indenting the task beneath it, oops, wrong button, there we go. We can see instantly it's turning green. So this view is always going to make summary tasks have a background of green and a foreground color of blue for the milestones. And you can do anything you want to these views. You can change the colors, you can do anything you want. But what we want to show, I will show you today, is how to save this view. Perhaps I want to use this same view on other projects. Okay, to save a view, I'm going to show you the way I do it. I'll come to the View ribbon. And the first thing I want to do is save the table. What I'm going to do, I'm going to bring up this small graphic here. Here's the step-by-step. This is actually an outtake from our training class on how to create all these kinds of things. This is just a quick outtake video on that. So the first thing I'm going to do is create a table, or utilize an existing one. I've kind of utilized an existing one, but made some changes. Why start from scratch, right? I could create a filter if I wanted to use on this view. Let's say I was creating a milestone view, I'd filter it just to show me the milestones in my project. I could also then group things in my project. So if I wanted to group by, let's say, you know, duration, or group by the resource name, I could do that, and that would be saved as part of the view. You can actually change out the screen layout. You can have certain views that would contain, let's say, the task form or the timeline, whatever the case may be. You can arrange things and it will remember the way in which you've arranged things. Once we've done all those options that we could potentially do, we can then save a view which kind of stitches all these things together. So a view is kind of like the thing that pulls all these various elements that you may or may not have created for your view. And I'll post these instructions in the blog. Okay, so back to here, I want to save the view. So as per the instructions, the first thing to do is to save the table. To do this, I actually click on the tables drop down in the view ribbon, click more tables, and then I can just click new, or I can actually click copy. I'm actually going to copy the entry table, which is the one I was currently working on. Copy it. I'm going to call this one video table. Press OK, and that's done. Press apply. I'm now currently using the video table. And I can see that by the drop down here. It's not in this list. If I click more tables, video table, I could actually edit it and make it appear in the list by checking the show in menu checkbox. Cool. It's always going to be in the list now of the tables. There it is at the top. So all that I've really adjusted in here is the table. I could go in here and put a grouping in. I could group by something, you know, like so. I could make my own grouping. I'm not going to do that for the sake of this video. I could also change the screen layout. I don't want to do that. I just want to do some real basic stuff. But you can get as complicated as you like. Essentially, the view, when I save it, is going to save the tables, filters and the groups, and the screen layout. So all I wanted to do was make changes to the table, which is this piece on the left hand side. So I'm now ready to save my view. To do this, I'm just going to click on the Gantt chart drop down. I'm going to click More Views, and I'm going to say Copy. It's going to be a copy of the Gantt chart, and you can see it's already picked up that the table that I was using was the video table. I'm going to call this the video view. You can see the grouping, no group, the filter, all tasks, just like we'd see above. I could make my own. I could utilize an existing one. I could create my own filter or utilize an existing one. I'm going to press OK. I'm going to apply. And on the left-hand side, I can see I've got my video view. And that'll always be there within this project schedule. Always going to be there. You may wish to have this particular view available in other project files. To do that, you'll actually need to utilize the Organizer tool within Microsoft Project. And that's another video that I'll be doing at some point. Thanks for listening today, and I hope you enjoyed it and found this useful. Thanks.